गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। इन द लास्ट थ्री लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस सम बेसिक फिजिक्स, सम बेसिक कंजर्वेशन लॉज, सम बेसिक फोर्सेस एंड द टॉपिक नेम इज सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर। आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस टॉपिक ऑल्सो, यू विल ऑल्सो स्टडी दिस इन योर केमिस्ट्री। यू नीड नॉट टू स्टडी दैट इन योर केमिस्ट्री। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक इन दिस फिजिक्स लेक्चर। ओके, significant, the word significant, what does this indicates? Significant means utmost importance, there's something that is of utmost importance. Okay, so in physics measurement is a very crucial portion of the physics. Without measurement or without the using the help of maths is the soul of the science. Maths is a powerful tool to understand various experiments, various phenomena that happens in natural life, various phenomena that you studied in your physics. Mathematics is an important tool to understand those phenomena. For example, you are going to experiment on this marker, you are going to free fall this marker. Okay, so in your experiment you need to find out what is the weight, what is the mass of this marker, with which velocity does it fall, with which acceleration does it fall. If I increase the mass of this marker or decrease the mass of this marker, how will with the acceleration and velocity the change? Okay, and if I will take two objects, which will fall first, which will come late. In experiment like this you need mathematics to solve all this, and you have already applied these laws in the 9th class, that how you find the acceleration, acceleration or velocity, etc. Okay, so the mathematics is a very important tool to study the physics, but the mathematics rules does not always follow in physics. For example, if I will ask you, I will write a number 0203. How many numbers are significant in this figure? You will say that you can remove this zero, still the number is same. So this zero have no importance. If a zero is leading, if zero is put in the beginning, that zero has no significance. You can either remove it, or you can take it as it is. Alright, so you will say that only these three numbers are of significance. So in this figure there are only three significant figure, this zero is not significant, Alright, that's clear to all of you. Now let's proceed further. I will take an example, 29.00. What will you say about this? Suppose this is time in seconds. I will ask you how many significant figures are there in this number. By seeing the previous example, you will say that this has no importance. If you apply the mathematics, you will say that this has no importance, that there are only these are of two. These two units are of more utmost significance, and you will say there are two significant figures, and this will be wrong according to physics. Why this is wrong? As physics says, in experiments the time is very crucial, the accuracy is very crucial of an experiment. In experiment the accuracy and precisions are very important. Alright, so if you ever see a 100 meter race, then the time is not measured only in second. There can be a difference of fraction of seconds. Have you ever seen the world records measured in seconds? They are also measured in milliseconds or the fraction of seconds. Alright, so that portion after, even after the second, if I have to stop a stopwatch at a particular time, when I am going to stop this, this also takes some time. Okay. Suppose I have to stop it at 29 seconds. When I am going to stop it at 29, the some fraction of time also passes out. If I did not measure that some fraction of time, this will be a loss in the calculations or in experiments. So in experiments, the calculations are very crucial, and a minor fraction difference will lead your calculation to some other way. So calculations are very crucial. So you have to very careful during calculations. So while measuring the time, you will try that you will measure the accurate time, even the small fraction that passes out when you were going to press that stopwatch button, you have to measure that fraction also and put it there, and you have to calculate the you have to do your measurements. All right, so that small fraction was also important. What does this indicate? That 29 seconds has passed out, and how many milliseconds after that pass out? This indicates that. All right, this can be 50, this can be 51, this can be 78, this can be 90, but some fraction does pass out when you press that button. All right, and that is also of utmost importance when doing calculations. So you cannot leave this portion. Okay, this is also of utmost significance. So you will say that there will be 4 significant figures according to physics, not 2 significant figures. So this topic of significant figures is connected to the accuracy, is connected to the accuracy of the apparatus. How accurate does a apparatus measure? All right, so there are some rules to find the number of significant figures in a digit, and we are going to discuss those rules made in physics. All right, okay, rules for finding significant figures in a number, in a digit. Okay, the very first rule is all non-zero numbers are significant. Okay, the first rule is all non-zero numbers are significant. Whenever you see a non-zero number, that will be significant. For example, if a number 203, it has 3 significant digits. Okay. Okay, not taking 203, I will take it in next example. 23, it has 2 significant digits. It will take 456, it has 3 significant figures. Or I will take 11134, it has 5 significant figures. Alright. Also, if I take 4.54, it has 3 significant figures. Okay. All the non-zero number which you will see in a digit, that will be significant. All non-zero numbers are significant. Okay, we have talked about non-zero numbers. Now we are going to proceed for the number which includes zero. Okay, so all trapped zeros matlab ki trapped zero means the zeros which are in between the two non zero numbers, or between two significant figures. The zero that is in between the two significant figures will be significant. Alright, all the zeros which are trapped between two non-zero numbers or two significant numbers is also significant. For example, if one will ask you how many significant digits are here, you will say this is non-zero number, this is significant, this is non-zero number, this is significant, and this zero is trapped between these non-zero numbers, this is also significant. So there are 3 significant figures. All right, one will ask you 1005. All right, we have one non-zero number, significant, these all are trapped between them, these all also significant, so we have here 5 significant figures. So all the trapped zeros, trapped zero means which are trapped between two non-zero numbers or which are trapped between two significant numbers, is also significant. All right, वी विल प्रोसीड फॉर द नेक्स्ट लॉ नंबर थ्री. ऑल द लीडिंग जीरोज आर नॉन सिग्निफिकेंट. ऑल वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट जीरोज. ऑल लीडिंग जीरोज. लीडिंग मीन्स दैट कम्स बिफोर ए नंबर. राइट. लीडिंग दैट कम्स इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ ए डिजिट. ऑल लीडिंग जीरोज आर नॉन सिग्निफिकेंट. नॉन सिग्निफिकेंट आई एम सेइंग वी विल नॉट कैलकुलेट देम एज सिग्निफिकेंट. राइट. ऑल लीडिंग जीरोज आर नॉन सिग्निफिकेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई आर विल आस्क यू 00529 दिस हैज ओनली थ्री सिग्निफिकेंट डिजिट्स एज दीज आर नॉन जीरो नंबर्स. दिस टू आर लीडिंग जीरोज. दिस विल नॉट काउंट एज सिग्निफिकेंट. राइट. अनदर इफ आई 0.00529 दिस ऑल्सो हैव थ्री सिग्निफिकेंट डिजिट्स. ओके. इफ आई विल आस्क यू 010101 देन इट हैज 10325 सिग्निफिकेंट डिजिट्स एज दीज आर ट्रैप जीरोज विच आर सिग्निफिकेंट. दिस इज लीडिंग जीरो विच इज नॉट सिग्निफिकेंट जीरो. राइट. इवन हेयर इफ ए डेसिमल पॉइंट हैज कम दीज आर लीडिंग जीरोज. लीडिंग जीरोज आर नेवर सिग्निफिकेंट. राइट. दिस वॉज द रूल नंबर थर्ड. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस रूल नंबर फोर. नाउ we are going to learn about rule number 4. What about trailing zeros? We have discussed trapped zero. We have discussed the zero which comes before a digit, that is leading zeros. What about the trailing zeros? All right. So trailing zeros, trailing means that comes in the end. Trailing zeros are significant. Trailing zeros are significant only when it comes after a decimal point. After a decimal point. Otherwise, trailing zeros are non-significant. Otherwise, trailing zeros are non-significant. If there is a decimal point and then the trailing zeros comes, then these are significant. Otherwise, they are non-significant. So, let me show some examples to you. I will ask you 5230. How many significant digits are there? There are only three significant digits as there is no decimal point. So, this is a trailing zero with no decimal point. That will be non-significant point. Okay, and why these are significant? Because these are non-zero numbers. So we have only three significant figures here. Let's discuss another. We have 325.00. Okay, how many significant figures are there? We have these are non-zero numbers. These are significant. We have these are trailing zeros. We have these are trailing zeros, but after the decimal point. If trailing zeros comes after the decimal point, those are count as significant. So this will be significant. This will also be significant. So we will have total of five significant figures in this number. Okay, let's proceed further. If we have 1.0052900, how many significant figures are there? Alright, this is the leading zero. Leading zeros are never significant. This is non-zero number, significant. Non-zero significant, non-zero significant, non-zero significant. This is a trapped zero. This is significant. This is significant. These zeros are trapped zeros. Trapped zeros between two non-zero numbers. The zeros are called trapped zeros. Trapped zeros are also significant. This is trailing zero. Trailing zero, but that comes after the decimal point, is count as significant. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, total of 7 significant figures in this number. Alright, let me ask another one. If we have 0.005290, how many significant figures are here? This is leading zero, this is leading zero, this is leading zero. Leading zero has never significant. Non-zero, 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 significant. This is trailing zero, but after the decimal point, this will count as significant. So we have only 4 significant figures in this digit. Alright, so we have talked about leading zero, trapped zero and trailing zero. We have talked about non-zero numbers. Let's continue our discussion further. Alright, the order of magnitude of a number is never significant. Next point is the order of magnitude of a number is never significant. Let me ask. Next is order of magnitude of a number is never significant. All right. What does order means? Whenever you write a number like this, 5 into 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power something, 10 to the power can be negative, can be positive, anything. Alright, this power is never significant. Okay, so how many significant digits are here? 1. How many here? 1. Alright, significant figures are 1 and 1. How will you write this? You will write it as 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 5 into 10 to the power 4. So you see that these are trailing zero without any decimal point. These are trailing zero without any decimal point. So this have only one significant figure. Let's write this. You can write it as 006 as the power is negative. The negative power means you are dividing by that number. Alright, you are dividing this 6 by 10 to the power 3. So this is a leading zero, leading zero, leading zero. These are not significant. All right, these are not significant. So there are only one significant figure. So if order of magnitude is given of a number of a digit, whether in positive powers or negative powers, that is never a significant figure. All right, let's proceed further. Suppose you have to convert one form of unit into the another form of unit. You have to convert the one form of unit into another form of unit, then the significant digits never changes. It's the most important point till now. If you convert one form of unit to another form of unit, then number of significant figure never changes. All right, number of significant figures never changes if you are converting one form of units into the another form of units. All right, what does this mean by converting one form of unit into another? For example, you are changing kilometer into meter, you are changing kilogram into gram, etc. All right, so if we have 4 kilometer, all right, 4 kilometer have one significant figure. All right, now let's you have to write into meter. You can write it as 4000 meter. All right, you can write it as 4000 meter. You can write it as 4 into 10 to the power 3 meter. 4 into 10 to the power 10 to the power 3 meter. Okay. You can write it as 0.4 into 10 to the power 4 meter. Alright. You can write it as 0.04 into 10 to the power 5 meter. Okay. Which one is correct? 4 kilometer has one significant digit. Find out the significant digit in this. These are leading trailing zero that are non-significant as the decimal point is not included. So there is only one significant figure. This is correct. You can write 4 kilometer as this. Alright. As the number of significant figures are same. In this number, we have already discussed if order of magnitude is given, that is not significant. So only this number is significant. So one significant figure, this is also correct. Okay, what about this number? This is non-significant. How many significant digits in this number? 1. This is also correct. Okay, as this is leading zero, this is not significant. This is non-zero number, this is significant. But you cannot write this number as this is non-significant, but after point this number is also not significant, this is significant. You can write this number as it is. Alright, you can write this number in this way. This is also correct. Okay, these all are correct because all have one significant digits. My question is, वी हैव 4 किलोमीटर, आई हैव टू कन्वर्ट दिस इन टू द मीटर यूनिट्स, कैन आई राइट इट एज 0.40 × 10⁻⁶. दिस हैज वन सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स, कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स हेयर. Order of magnitude is not significant. This is leading zero, which is not significant. This is non-zero number, which is significant. This zero comes after the decimal point, which is significant. So you will write it as 2 significant figures. Okay, you have converted the unit from kilometer to meter, and you find out that there were only 1 significant figure, and after converting, there are 2 significant figures. The number of significant figures does never change after changing the unit, so you cannot write this as in physics. Mathematically, this is correct. Alright, mathematically you will see that this can be written as this, this can be written as this, this will be 10, this will be into 10 to the power 5. I have to made it 3, alright. Take it as 4, alright. This will be equal to 4 × 1 3. Alright. Take it as 4. Okay. Still, there are 2 significant figures which are not equal to significant figure given in the first form of units. So, as the number of significant units are not same, so the number is no. This form cannot be written. Alright, as the number of significant figures are not same. Alright, let's come to the next point. In a constant, number of significant figures are infinite. For example, a constant like pi, the value of pi, there are number of significant figures infinite. That means the constant quantities are calculated using experiments and that are most accurate values. For example, speed of light, the value of pi, Boltzmann constant, gravitational constant, they are more accurate. The every digit on those numbers, in these numbers, are significant. Alright, so they are infinite number of significant. They are of utmost significance. Alright, all constants are of utmost significance. So, like speed of light, refractive index, gravitational constant, electric permittivity, there are infinite number of significant figures. Okay, the number itself are important. Every digit in those numbers are important. These are some of the rules to finding the significant figures. Let's discuss some of the questions and then we will proceed how to do calculations using significant figures. Okay, let's do some questions. We have 40 × 10⁶. How many significant figures are there? We have 0.0286 × 10⁻³. We have 10.0100. We have 010100. Alright. We have 1.01. We have 1.100.10. Alright. So how many significant figure? This is not significant. This is also non-significant, as this is trailing zero. This is non-zero number. This is significant. Only one significant. If I will talk about this, this is non-significant. This is leading zero non-significant. Leading zero non-significant. These three are non-zero numbers. These three are significant. If I will talk about this, alright. This is non-zero significant. This is non-zero significant. This zero, these zeros are trapped between these two non-zero numbers. Trapped zeros are also significant. So this is also significant. This is also significant. If I will talk about these two zeros, these are trailing zeros. But after the decimal point, that also counts as significant. So we have 6 significant figures in this number. Let's talk about this. This is leading zero, that is not significant. This is trailing zeros. These are trailing zeros that are non-significant, as no decimal point is included. This is significant, this is significant, this is trap zero, this is significant. So only 3 significant figures in this digit. If I will talk about this, significant, significant, trap zero, significant, 3 significant figures are there. If I will talk about this, significant, significant, this is trap zero, significance, and this is also significant as the decimal point is included, then the trailing zeros are also significant, that we have total of 3 or 5 significant figures in this number. So I hope if any question given to you about the significant figures, you can in a digit you can calculate it easily. All right, let's come to the next topic, that is how to calculate, how to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division in significant using the method of significant figures. All right, we are going to do calculation on the basis of significant figures. Calculations on the basis of significant figure. Before that, an important topic, or you can say an very short topic which you already know in your mathematics, rounding of a number. We are going to learn about this rounding off a number. We have already known that suppose I am going to round off these numbers up to two decimal places. Round off these two numbers up to two decimal places. We have a number like 5.28. 5.289. All right. So you have to write only two numbers after decimal. Okay. So there are three numbers after the decimal point. You have to remove this number. Okay. Whenever you are removing this number, listen carefully. You have to round off up to two decimal points. That is, after decimal there are only two number. There should be only two numbers. All right. So you know, you don't have any need of this third number. You have to remove this number. But when you have to remove this number, you have to be careful. All right. How will you do remove this number? How do you remove this number? Which number you have to remove? Check it. If this number is less than 5 or greater than 5. All right. Check it. If this number is less than 5 or greater than 5. If number is greater than 5, as in this case, this is 9. This is greater than 5. If number is greater than 5, then when you remove this number, you will add one digit to the previous number. Then answer will be, then add 1 in previous digit. This will be result in 5.2. This was 8 in the first. When you remove 9, this will become 9. You have added 1 into this. All right, what you have to be careful about, which number you have to remove, is that number greater than 5 or less than 5. If it is greater than 5, then you have to you need not to think about it. Remove it and add 1 to the previous digit. All right, let's take another example. If this will be equal to 5.287, then answer will be 5.29. okay, what will happen if the number is less than 5? If number is less than 5, then you remove that number and don't add or subtract anything. Leave the number as it is. Alright, if the number is like this, 5.284, then when you remove this number, you check it, this number is less than 5, then answer will be 5.28. You does not add or subtract anything. Alright, so these were easy rules. If number is greater than 5, you will add 1 to the previous digit. If number is less than 5, you neither add or remove to the previous digit. You keep it as it is. Alright. What will happen if the number is equal to 5? What will happen if the number is equal to 5? Equal to 5. Then you have to check for the two cases. Alright. Check for the trailing number that comes after that number, which you have to remove. For example, 5.29853. Alright. You have to remove this number. all right, you have to remove this number. Actually, you have to remove both these to find the answer up to 2 decimal places. All right, you have to remove both these numbers. So after 2 decimal place, this number comes, and the third place, you have to remove this. You check this number is equal to 5. You checked that this number is equal to 5. All right. Equal to 5. Okay. If the number, if the trailing number after this, if trailing number after this 5 is non-zero, trailing number is non-zero. If trailing zero is, trailing number is non-zero, then you simply add 1 to the previous number. Suppose this is 8. Alright. Then you have to add 1 to the previous number. But you have to check if the trailing number after 5 is non-zero or 0. Trailing number after 5 is non-zero or 0. If it is non-zero, then you have to add 1 in the previous number. The answer will be 5.29. Another example I am taking. 2.5651. You have to convert it up to 2 decimal places. So you have to remove these 2 points. But you check that this number is 5 and this number is non-zero. This number is non-zero. So after removing this, you will add simply 1 to this. But you have to check whether this number is greater than 5, less than 5 or equal to 5. We have discussed that if number is greater than 5, you will simply add 1 digit to the previous number, previous digit. If number is less than 5, you don't have to do anything, just remove that number. If number is equal to 5, then you have to check the tracing or trailing number. And if trailing number is non-zero, then simply add 1 to the previous digit. Alright, what happen if this number is equal to 0? What will happen if this number is equal to 0? If trailing number is 0, 5450, if number is like this, you find out that this is 5, you have to remove these both these points for 2 decimal places. You find out that this number is equal to 5 and the trailing number is 0, then check for the previous number. Then check for the previous number. If previous number is even, then leave it as it is. The answer will be 2.54. Another example, if we have 3.2150, you have to remove both these. This number is equal to 5, this is equal to 0, and you check the previous number. If this previous number is odd, if this previous number is odd, then simply add 1 to them. Then answer will be 3.22. Alright, if the leading number is, if the trailing number is 0 after the 5, then you have to check the previous digit. If previous digit is even, then leave as it is. Then leave as it is. And if this is odd, then add one. Alright. These are the various rules of rounding off. I will giving you an example. You have the number of 5.28. Suppose there is, alright, 281. When you remove this, this answer will be 5.28 as the number is less than 5. 5.285. When you remove this, if there are no trailing number given, that can be supposed as 0. You have to remove this. Okay. This number is equal to 5. Last number is 0. The previous number is even. When this number is even, you write the number as it is. The answer will be 5.28. The answer will be 5.28. Okay. If the number is like this, 2851, you check that you have to remove this number. This is equal to 5. This is non-zero. If this number is non-zero, just simply add 1 to this. That will be 5.29. If this number be like this, 5.2750, you have to remove this. This number is equal to 5, this number is equal to 0. And when this number is 0, you have to check the previous digit. Previous digit is odd number. If previous digit is odd number, then simply add to 1 to this. That answer will be 5.28. So these are the rules of rounding of a number. So next we have calculations using significant figures. By calculation, we mean addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Alright. So these are very simple. And now first I am going to discuss about multiplication. एंड डिवीजन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिवीजन. वाइल डूइंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन और डिवीजन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू द टू डिजिट थ्री डिजिट और फोर डिजिट विच यू आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई इन दोज नंबर्स व्हेन यू मल्टीप्लाई देम द कैलकुलेशन इज अफेक्टेड बाय द लीस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर द डिजिट विच हैव लीस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर्स. ऑलराइट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर डूइंग सम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स and 2% find you have to give the answer by averaging out on the values. There are 3% which are performing the experiment, and what you have to do after they do perform the experiment, you have to grab the data and average out and find the result. You will take the data from all three of them, you will average that out and you will find the answer. Now suppose person 1 accurately measure whatever the experiment is about. Person 2 also accurately measure whatever the experiment is about. But person 3 does the mistake. So person 1 gives the significant result because his result was correct. Person 2 also gives the very significant result. But person 3 gives the result which was of least significance. Alright, now you have to average that out. So when the final result come out, you will see that your result and the experimental result, your result and the result which is known before does not match. Where does this this situation comes from? Where do they get wrong? They get wrong from the third person which record the readings faulty. It does not record them accurately. It was his least significance observations which leads to falsity, which leads to this faulty experiment or error. There is error in the experiment due to is inaccurateness. Alright, so an experiment is most affected by the person which gives the least significant result. Alright, in the same way, when you multiply or divide a number, the result is affected by the number which has the least significant digits. Alright, so the multiplication and division, the result can never be more accurate. The result can never be more accurate than the least significant number included into multiplication and division. The result cannot be more accurate than the number which is least significant in multiplication and division. All right, also the result cannot have more significant figures than the least significant figure digit during multiplication or division. The two numbers which you are going to multiply or divide, the one number which have least significant number of digits, the number which have least significant of digits, the result will also have that number of significant figures. The result will have the same number of, you can write it as, the result will have the same number of significant figures as the least significant figure digit while multiplying or divide. The two numbers which you are going to multiply or divide, the number which have least significant digit or digits figures, so the result will also have that number of significant figures. It cannot have more than that significant figure or less than that significant figures. Alright, now I am going to show you some example. These are very common example which are going to discuss today. Alright. Let's multiply 28.05 multiply by 38.2. Alright, let's multiply them. First you have to write the answer. Multiply them 28.05 multiply by 38.2. The answer will be 1071.51. Alright. Okay. So you check the number of significant digits in this number and number of significant figures in this number. How many significant figures are there? Non-zero, 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 trapped zero. These are four significant figures. Non-zero, non-zero, non-zero. There are three significant figures. Which have least? This one have the least significant figures. So the answer cannot have more than three significant figures. Alright. So we have to only write it as 107. Okay. So let's proceed further. We have to multiply like 1.01 multiply by 1.0010. Alright. We have to multiply by 1.01 multiply by 1.0010. Then our answer will be 1.011101. Now check the significant numbers. Non-zero, non-zero, trap zero. There are three significant figures. Non-zero, non-zero, trap zero. These all are significant. This is also significant as this is trailing zero and after come potential after the decimal point. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are five significant digits. So the answer cannot have more than three significant figures. So answer should be right as up to three significant figures. All right. check this again. You have to write it up to the three significant figures. Alright, means you have to write up to these places. So you have to remove all these points. Alright, you have to remove 1, you have to remove 5, you have to remove 1. When you remove this 5, as this number is equal to, you have learned the rules of rounding off. As this number is equal to 5 and the trailing number is non-zero, so what you do? When the number is equal to 5 and trailing number is equal to non-zero, trailing number is non-zero, then you simply add 1 to the previous number. When you're rounding off up to these points, the answer will be this. But you have to write it up to 3 points. Alright, still this number got 4 points. So you also have to remove this point. This point is less than 5. If this point is less than 5, you can simply remove that and the answer will be 107. Alright. Alright. So what we have to do? We have to write the answer up to 3 significant figures. How many significants in the result? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 significant figures are there. You have to write it up to 3 significant digits. So you have to 1 significant, 2 significant, 3 significant. You have to remove all these numbers. As you check, all these numbers are less than 5, less than 5. So rounding off rule, what does rounding off says? If these numbers are less than 5, you simply remove them without changing any digit. So answer will be 1.01. So in this way, whether you divide or whether you multiply, the answer will have the same number of significant figures as present in the least significant number. The answer, the result will have the same number of significant as present in the least significant number. Alright. So in this way, you will give the result of multiplication and division using significant figures. Alright. Let's proceed further for addition and subtraction. इन एडिशन और सब्ट्रैक्शन यू हैव राइट द रिजल्ट अप टू द सेम नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल पॉइंट्स एज प्रेजेंट इन द नंबर विच हैव द लीस्ट नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल प्लेसेस. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, यू हैव टू राइट द आंसर अप टू द सेम नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल प्लेसेस एज प्रेजेंट इन द नंबर विच हैव द लीस्ट नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल पॉइंट्स. All right, whether you have to do the rounding off or you need not to do that, but you have to write the result after the rounding off. So answer will be, the result will be, please listen carefully, I am saying the result have the same number of decimal point. I am not saying the same number of significant figure. I am saying the result will have the same number of, the result will have the same number of decimal point, same number of decimal places as present in the number which have least number of decimal places by rounded off. You need to take the help of rounding a number. Alright, so let's discuss one or two examples, then we'll close the topic today. For example, we have to add 29.0057 and 1.023. All right. How many decimal places are there? 4. How many decimal places are there? 3. So answer can have the same number of decimal places as present in the number which have least number of decimal places, which have the least this number. That is, the answer will have only 3 number of decimal places. You have to calculate it after the rounding. How will you add them? 1.023, you will add them. This will be 782003. This will be the answer. But what you have to do, you have to write it as the same, up to the same decimal places up to which the least number have the only 3 decimal places. So you have to write this answer up to 3 decimal places. After decimal there can be only 3 numbers. So you have to remove this number by using the rules of rounding off. So you check that this number is greater than 5. What you do, when you remove this number, you will add 1 to this. So answer will be 30.029. All right, as simple as it is. Another example you can do is 7.82954 minus 1.02. All right, you have to subtract 1.02. This number has 2 decimal places, this number has 5 decimal places, so answer would have 2 decimal places only. You will subtract it, this will be 459086. So and you have to write the answer up to 2 decimal places. You have to remove all these. Alright, when removing all these, when you remove this number, you check that this number is greater than 5. If this number is greater than 5, then simply you will add 1 to this number. The answer will be 6.81. This will be wrong, this will be right, if you follow the rules of significant figures or rounding off. These were the calculations using significant figures. This can also given as like 6 into 10 to the power 4 multiply by 5 into 10 to the power 3. Yeah, or 5.03 into 10 to the power 3. How many significant numbers are there? What you have to do is, you know that when multiply by 6 and 5.03, how many significant figures are there? 1. How many significant figures are there? 3. So the answer would have only 1 significant figure. Multiply it and write it to up to the 1 number. All right. So these were the questions. Thank you. You can tell me any doubt. if you have any doubt, you can tell me in the comment section.